On our previous video, we helped this noob reach second C using the Dofu. So guys, we're just gonna continue this video, and if ever you were not able to watch it, I will put the link on the upper right side of the screen, the level 1 to level 1500 video, and also I will put the link of that video in the description. So before we start, I made a Twitter account for this channel for future updates, announcements, and giveaways. And one more thing, you can show your support by using star code GamerNom when buying your Robux. Okay, so are you ready to grind this account until you reach max level? If you're ready, let's go!
Where the Echo Slam!
Oh, there it is!
Passing forward! There's your slam! There's the dunk!
Hello! GamerNom is back. So for today's video, we're going to continue helping this noob reach max level using the Dofu. So as you can see, we are in the second C, but as we all know, the minimum requirement for leveling up in second C is level 2250. So here we are, we're going back to the first C, and in the zombie island, we're gonna start defeating the zombies. They're easy to defeat, don't worry. You need to defeat 5, right? So two ways, use your rapidly punches to lure all zombies and use your B skill. But there is a faster way, use your X skill, the heat shot. Use your Z skill here, the flexible punch. And here you're gonna use your sharpened spike. There you go, and one more flexible punch, and that's it. So for the goal level here, you need to reach level 1600, and after that, you can now start defeating the Shadow Master. So guys, he's easy to defeat. Just use your rapidly punches until you defeat him. You can also avoid his skills by just jumping high in the air, and that's it. There's also a chance that you can get this dark orb here wherein you can summon a boss, or you just need to put it here in this hole and there you go. So you can defeat him 1v1 guys, as long as you're out of his range, use your V skill, X skill, and that's enough. But don't worry, if you're in the public server, when the sky turns dark, everyone knows they will go in this area and they will help you defeat Ors. Okay, so the goal level here is to reach level 2801, and after that, you can now proceed to the Marineford. That's the same. We're gonna start here with the Rear Admirals. You need to defeat 6. It's very easy. Use your B skill, jump, X skill, and that would be enough. Wait for them to spawn and do it again. So by doing that, you will finish a quest. And the goal here is to reach level 1850. And after that, we can now proceed to our next target, the True Karate Fishman. So he's easy to defeat, but he has some skills that's really hard to dodge. But still, he's easy to defeat. Turn on your observation haki. So it's your choice. If you wanna go back to the Rear Admirals, it's fine. Defeat him. But the goal level here is to reach level 1925. So when you reach that, you can now go here to the Quake Woman. He's easy to defeat. You can defeat him long range if you want. Just use your V skill and X skill. Anyways, the goal here is to reach level 2100. To be honest, all the enemies here is easy to defeat, but you really need to be patient. So when you reach that level, you can now go to the Fishland and start defeating the Combat Fishman. But GamerNom, the level requirement for this mob is 2050, why wait for 2100? My reason here is after defeating that mob, you can proceed here to the Swordfishman. There you go, Swordfish, sorry. And defeat them simultaneously. So defeating two mobs is better, right? And faster, more efficient. So the goal here is to reach level 2200. Okay. So after that, you can now proceed to your final mob. And that mob is the Seasoned Fishman. So you can defeat him by just using your X skill and your V skill. There you go. X skill here. Make sure to hit him. Use your observation haki to see him properly. Go. It's easy compared to when we were grinding the map, right? Okay, so the goal level here is to reach level 2350. We're gonna take advantage of all the levels that we can get here because we're gonna skip some quests on the second scene. So off to the starting island, let's talk to the Elite Pirate. There you go, and second scene, we are back. Okay, so here we're gonna start with the Snake Man. Again, level requirement 2350. We will focus on single target enemies. So again, use your X skill, V skill or B skill, it really depends to you guys. Try to like use different skills so that you won't get bored. Okay. Okay, the goal here is to reach level 2500, and after that, we can proceed to our next quest or mob target. Let's proceed to that area. There you go. The Hibernus Land, and that target or mob is the Violet Samurai. Is he, she hard to defeat? To be honest, every enemy here is easy to defeat. So you just need to be patient. X skill, B skill, V skill, that's enough. Okay? No problems with that. Turn on your observation haki to make sure and be aware of those bounty hunters. So the goal here is to reach level 2550. And after that, we will proceed to our next target again. And it is located here in the Floresco. And that target is the Rabbit Man. Same strategy, guys. X, B, V skill. Gamer Gnome, were you targeted by bounty hunters? Guys, a lot. A lot of times. So I used to run, etc. A lot. So there you go. Goal here is to reach level 2600. And after that, we are gonna proceed to our next target mob again. And that target is the Batman. There you go, Batman. Okay, so guys, he's easy to defeat. How to make things faster? Defeat the Batman, right? And after that, you can go back to the previous mob, the Rabbit Man. Go defeat the Rabbit Man, and then go back to the Batman. Okay, I hope that's clear. The goal level here is to reach level 2650, and after that, you can now go to the Kitsune Samurai. Again, same strategy. Defeat the Kitsune Samurai, and after that, you can go back to the nearest mob that is still within level range, the Rabbit Man. There you go. Defeat the Rabbit Man and go back to the Kitsune Samurai. So the goal here is to reach level 2850. There you go. That's the max level for the Kitsune Samurai. There you go. After that, you can now proceed to Carcere and start defeating the Bear Man. So again, no problem defeating him. X skill, B skill, V skill. Okay. The goal level here is to reach level 2900, and after that, you can now proceed, or guys, you can stay here. I'm gonna show it to you. Now proceed to Torifasho and start defeating the Patchy Woman. Guys, what I don't like with this Patchy Woman is that it has a blink Soru. It will go towards you and damage you, so you cannot dodge that. So if you wanna chill and just reserve your observation haki for bounty hunters, go to the Bear Man. There you go. The goal here is to reach level 2950, and after that, you can now go to Viridians and start defeating Kappa. So Kappa is kinda easy to defeat. I don't know, maybe it has lower HP compared to other mobs, but he can damage you. Okay, so the goal here is to reach level 3000, and after that, our next target is the Mammoth Man. Check this out, guys. In the final island, the Loaf Island, the sunken vessel will give you 461,000 experience. This is a mini boss here, again, sunken vessel. Next up, we have the Biscuit Man that will give you 464,000, and the Dough Master, 468,000. Guys, let's compare it with the Mammoth Man. Guys, this mob will give you 544,000, which is higher. So we will maximize that. Again, this mob will give you the highest experience. Guys, not including the bosses like Kaido, Big Mom, or the Sea Beasts. Our goal level here is to reach level 3200, and after that, we will proceed to our next island, which is the final island, the Loaf Island. This island is just placed beside the Skull Island, so first we're gonna focus on the chess soldiers. As they're so easy to defeat, you can use your Dose Pin to lure them, and after that, use your X skill, B skill, and Z skill to defeat your enemies. Goal here is to reach level 3250, and after that, you can proceed to your next target, which is the Biscuit Man. Don't need to defeat the Sunken Vessel or the Dough Master, but if you want to unlock older items like the swords, the accessories, go for it. But guys, defeating Biscuit Man is so easy. You don't need to like go near it. Just use your X and V skill. Or just in case he attacks you, use your C skill. Remember, your liquid drops in order to stun or stop him. Don't mind the dog. Anyways, guys, you can actually reach max level here, 3300. But again, if you want more action, etc., you can start defeating the Domaster when you reach level 3275. So let's try that. That mob is located in this area, in the castle. To the left, the mirror, here, and there you go. Guys, aside from the bosses, this mob is one of the strongest mob. It will really hit you, so make sure to bring your A-game whenever you're fighting him. So we're just gonna stun this, use our skills, and oof this mob. There you go. And that's it, guys. We've reached max level 3,300. Again, if you have requests, just comment it in the comment section. Again, to all the viewers, subscribers, supporters, I appreciate y'all. This is GamerNom, and GamerNom out.